Dear students, welcome to theory session number 10 on the chapter of chemical bonding in physical chemistry. In our last theory session, we did our discussion upon the molecular orbital theory, and also we drew the different molecular orbital configuration of a few molecules. In this theory session, we will be starting our discussion with the drawing of a few more molecular configurations of a few different other molecules, and then we will try our hand at depicting the molecular orbital diagram. Now, before I start with the different molecular orbital configurations, I hope you all remember the relative order of energies for the atomic orbitals. If you remember the relative order of energies for the atomic orbitals, you will find that for these molecules, that is the lithium, beryllium, boron and carbon, and nitrogen, the order is as follows, that is sigma 1s, then sigma 1s star, then sigma 2s, then sigma 2s star, then pi y is equal to pi z, then comes sigma x, then comes pi y star, which is equal to pi z star, and lastly comes a sigma x star. So this is the relative order of energies if we have the molecules lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon and nitrogen. Now we will start our discussion by drawing the MO configuration for carbon. So the carbon molecule is represented by C2, and carbon has an electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So this is the electronic configuration for carbon. Now in a C2 molecule, there is a total of 12 electrons. Hence, we can accommodate the 12 electrons as such that we have sigma 1s bonding first, then sigma 1s antibonding, then sigma 2s bonding, then sigma 2s antibonding, then comes pi y bonding is equal to pi z bonding. One thing is to be noted that the expression of a bonding molecular orbital can be given with a small b. Also the absence of that small b represents a bonding orbital too. Only an antibonding orbital is represented by with the help of an asterisk or with the help of a star. So if we have 12 molecules, we can accommodate those 12 molecules as such. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we can write the configuration for carbon like this. Sigma 1 is bonding 2, sigma 1 is antibonding 2, sigma 2 is bonding 2, sigma 2 is antibonding 2, pi y bonding 2 is equal to pi z bonding 2. Now we can find that there are no unpaired electrons. So there are no unpaired electrons in the C2 molecule. Therefore, we can say that C2 is diamagnetic. Also, we can calculate the bond order with the help of the below given formula. That is, bond order is equal to NB minus NA divided by 2. NB is the number of electrons in the bonding orbital, NA representing the number of electrons in the antibonding orbital, divided by 2. So if you look at the number of electrons that are there in the bonding orbital, there it is 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and the number of electrons in the antibonding orbital are 2 and 2, 4. Therefore it is 8 minus 4 divided by 2, which is equal to 2. Therefore the bond order in C2 molecule is equal to 2. Now after carbon we can draw the bond order for the fluorine molecule. We can calculate the bond order and draw the molecular orbital diagram for the fluorine molecule. So our next topic is MO configuration . Fluorine has an atomic number 9 with configuration 1s2, 2s2. So this is the configuration for fluorine. So in F2 molecule there are 18 electrons to be accommodated. So total we have to accommodate 18 electrons. Now this can be arranged in the fluorine molecular orbitals as such. So we come to the MO configuration of we can write this as such, sigma 1s star, then sigma 2s, then sigma 2s star. Now here first sigma x bonding will come, then pi y is equal to pi z will come in the relative energy order, because the relative energy order for oxygen, for fluorine and for neon is a little different. So there are 18 electrons and this can be arranged as such, 1, 2. Always remember that the filling of the electrons in the molecular orbitals takes place according to the three rules you have studied. Those are the Aufbau principle, the Hund's rule for maximum multiplicity and the Pauli's exclusion principle. So the first two electrons have been arranged. Next comes 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So after pi z it will come pi star y is equal to pi star z, and lastly it will come sigma x star. So we have arranged already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 electrons have been arranged. Then we have to arrange 4 more electrons. So it is 15, 16, 17, 18. So overall we can write the configuration as such, 1s2, sigma 1s antibonding 2, sigma 2s 2, sigma 2s antibonding 2, sigma x bonding 2, pi y bonding 2 is equal to pi z bonding, pi y antibonding is equal to pi z antibonding, and lastly is sigma x antibonding. So in the pi y bonding we have 2 electrons, in the pi z bonding again 2 electrons, in the pi star antibonding we have 2 electrons, in the pi z star antibonding we have 2 electrons. So we have arranged 14 electrons, and F2 molecule is a diamagnetic molecule. So first thing we can write, F2 molecule is a diamagnetic molecule. Next we have to calculate the bond order of the F2 molecule, which is equal to NB minus NA divided by 2. NB is the number of electrons in the bonding orbital, NA is equal to the number of electrons in the antibonding orbital, and that number divided by 2 will give you the bond order. Now we have to calculate the number of electrons in the bonding orbital. Here we have 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and the number of electrons in the antibonding orbital is equal to 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Therefore we can say this value is equal to 10 minus 8 divided by 2, which is equal to 1. It has been found that the F2 molecule is a stable molecule with the bond dissociation energy equal to 151 kilojoule per mole.